This book is called Orion and the Dark, and it's by Emma Yarlett. My name is Orion, and I guess you could say I'm scared of a lot of things. Mum tells me I just have a big imagination and there's nothing to be frightened of. Well, that's easy for her to say. As far as I can see, the world is full of frightening things. But there is one thing that scares me more than anything else. The dark. Of course, I've tried all kinds of things to solve the problem, but nothing ever worked, and before I know it, it's bedtime again. Good night, Orion. Good night, Mom. I hate bedtime. The night that changed everything began like any other. I kept an eye out for monsters. I kept an ear out for scary noises, but as it got darker and darker and darker, I couldn't take it anymore. I've had enough of you, Dark! I wish you and your scary sounds, your murky monsters and your pitch blackness would just go away! And that's when something strange happened. Gibbering jellyfishes! Outside my window, the dark seemed to come alive. And a thing I've never seen before dropped in for a visit. I was feeling more scared than ever before, even more than when I went to that seaside dog show with Gran. But Mum always says it is important to remember your manners, especially when you're greeting monsters, visitors. So I said, hello, I'm Orion, and offered to shake his hand.
Hello, I'm the Dark. Now Orion, it's time for you to stop being so afraid of everything, especially me. Let's go on an adventure.
Of course, normally I'd be scared stiff of going on an adventure, especially with a terrifying creature like Dark. Except, this Dark wasn't quite what I had expected. First, he asked to see the shadowy and scary bits of the house, the nooks and crannies where the monsters live. One in the wardrobe, two under the bed, three down the plug hole, and four in the basement. And you won't believe this, but some of the darkest places turned out to be the most fun. Even having fun couldn't stop me from being scared for long though. Dark! What are those horrible, creepy and scary sounds coming from outside? Tick-tock, tick-tock, tap-tap-tap, croak, hiss, oh, zum, bang, murmur, squeak, 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 mumble, mwah, clank. To find the frightening sounds, and when we found them, they weren't frightening at all. Crikey, that's just Dad, silly. Ha ha, that's no monster. The nighttime is much more interesting than the daytime. Dark asked me if I'd stopped feeling afraid. The horrible wiggly feeling had definitely gone a bit, but there was still one place that made my knees wobble and my tummy twist with fright. The awful place where the dark is darkest of all. And so off we went. On one last adventure, all the way up into the night sky. There, in the darkest place of all, suddenly I knew. When I stopped worrying about being scared, dark could be fun, and dark could be interesting, and dark could be magical, and most of all, dark could be my friend, and nobody, not even me, is scared of their best friend. friend began to fade. It was time to say goodbye. Dark, I've had such a super duper spiffadocious incredimundo adventure, but will you ever come back? I didn't want Dark to go, and so he promised.
I'll never be far away.
And from that night on, he never was.